Now, this is a track and field that we have been waiting for. After seeing so many small meets all around the world, the Monaco Diamond League really delivered and put down some of the greatest performances that we've seen throughout the entire year. First off, of course, we saw Joshua Cheptegei in that men's 5,000 meters ran away with a world record performance of 12 minutes, 35.36 seconds, absolutely obliterating the previous world record set by Kenenisa Bekele all the way back in 2004, 16 years ago. This was a masterful performance. Of course, Cheptegei already had the world records on the road in the 15K and the 5K. He also previously had that 10K road world record, but this was really where it's at. Of course, he also got the 10K world championship gold medal last year. This just shows that he is the premier distance runner in the sport of track and field. Of course, he is the clear favorite going into Tokyo next year. Definitely going to be looking to potentially go for that double, adding on to that gold medal he got in Doha last year. Cheptegei is going to be a mainstay in the sport for years to come. So definitely keep an eye out for him. I think he's potentially going to get that 10K world record on the track as well. And unfortunately, Bekele might get erased from those world record books. But definitely keep a lookout for Cheptegei. A lot more to come from him. Now, dropping down to the sprints, we saw Noah Lyles in the 200 meters, his first race overseas after a couple of them down in Florida, came away with a very commanding win, 19.76 seconds. So just edges ahead of Kenny Benarek, who ran 19.8 just a couple days ago. But Noah Lyles showing his dominance, no competition from the rest of the field. He was joined actually by his brother in second place, who ran 20.30 seconds. But again, this is all about Noah Lyles. He is not letting up. He's showing that he is steps ahead of the rest of the field, and he is only in competition with the clock. Definitely the gold medal favorite in Tokyo next year. Now, a little off distance, we saw the women's 1,000 meter run instead of the 800 or the 1,500 meters, but Faith Kipyegon from Kenya, the 2016 Olympic champion in the 1,500 meters, came away with a dominating performance. 2 minutes, 29.15 seconds, makes her just off the world record in the event, number two all time in the 1,000 meters. Of course, the event isn't very frequently run, but this is still a commanding performance, showing that she is not letting up. Probably the only other woman who can really definitely beat her is Sifan Hassan, but she wasn't in this race. Right behind her from Great Britain, we saw Laura Muir. She came away with a personal best, 2 minutes, 30.82 seconds. And Sierra McGeehan from Ireland, she managed to get third in 2 minutes, 31.06 seconds. But again, Faith Kipyegon, this was all about her. And I think she's going to be the favorite going into those Olympics in the 1500 meter run. Back on the sprinting side, but this time with the hurdles, this was all about Carsten Warholm in those 400 meter hurdles. He had no competition. Rye Benjamin or Samba, they were not in this race. So it was all about Carsten Warholm. Of course, he knows he gets out very aggressively, goes over those hurdles, comes away, doesn't let up, and he delivered here. 47.10 seconds, his second fastest time in his entire career, and is actually the eighth fastest performance in history. Of course, we already know that he's second all time with his 46.92 seconds, but this just shows his consistency. One of the most consistent athletes under 47.50 seconds in the hurdles. So I think Warholm is probably still the favorite. Of course, Benjamin and Samba are definitely going to be right on his heels, but Warholm, two-time world champion, he is going to be the favorite going into the Olympics next year. Now, back up in the 1500 meters, but this time on the men's side, another very high quality performance, Timothy Cheruiyot. Now, he is known to go out very fast, to command the pace, and to pull everyone to some fast times. Here, he did not disappoint. He probably went a little bit off the pace, and when I say off the pace, he probably went a little bit too fast. He could have edged back a little bit, got a little bit faster time, but he still ran 3:28.41 seconds, just off his own personal best. But again, he dragged the rest of the field to some very fast times. Jakob Ingebrigtsen from Norway came away with a European record of 3:28.68 seconds. Behind them from Great Britain, Jake Wigman, he managed to get 3:29.47 seconds. So I think Ingebrigtsen is really one to note here. He really challenged Cheruiyot all the way to the end. Again, I think Cheruiyot went out way too fast for what the pace was really going for here, but Cheruiyot is definitely going to be the favorite. Ingebrigtsen is going to be right on his heels, and Ingebrigtsen is much younger, so he's going to have a lot more potential and a lot more opportunities to improve. But still, Cheruiyot, I still think, is that favorite, and there's going to be a lot of guys he's going to bring to some fast times, just like this race here. Now, back down in the 800 meters on the men's side, we saw Donovan Brazier. He has been really tearing it up out in Oregon in the United States. His first first race in Europe, and he did not disappoint. World-leading performance of 1:43.15. He did have some challenge, though, by his fellow American, Bryce Hoppel. He got away with a personal best of 1:43.23. So right on the heels of Donovan Brazier. Donovan Brazier usually has a commanding lead, but this was a good showing for Hoppel. In third place, Marco Arop from Canada. He led from most of the race, actually, but came away with a personal best as well, 1:44.14. So again, Donovan Brazier, absolutely commanding win. He is obviously the favorite to go for that gold medal in Tokyo to follow up that gold medal he got in Doha. Heading over to the 5,000 meters, but this time on the women's side. Now, this race was really supposed to be about Safwan Hassan. She was going for potentially something very fast, but she got to about 4,000 meters and pulled out of the race. Don't know if she's injured, don't know if something happened. Hopefully she is still healthy, because we know that she loves to run fast and she does have some other races coming up later on this year. But it turned out to be Helen Obiri, the world champion in the 5,000 meters a couple times, and she came away with the win, 14:22.12. Very comfortable win. Of course, we know that she's run much faster, but I think Safwan Hassan is going to be going for the double, the 5K, 10K double in Tokyo. So Safwan Hassan might be the favorite, but Helen Obiri, she is showing no signs of letting up. Also have to note a couple ladies behind her, Letesenbek Gide from Ethiopia. She came away just in second place. Remember, she got the silver medal in the 10K last year in Doha. We also had Laura Waitman from Great Britain. We had Jessica Hull from Australia, Shannon Roberry from the United States. A lot of great women running some fast times in this 5K. But again, Helen Obiri taking the win here, definitely one to look out for in Tokyo next year. Now, we did have a couple other performances in the women's 400 meters. Lena Irby got the win ahead of Wadlin Jonathan. I think this is notable for Lena Irby in the 400. Remember, she ran that 49.8 seconds about 2 years ago, winning that NCAA championships. But she's been kind of up and down. Remember, she went pro after ending her NCAA career a little bit early. She didn't have a great 2019 season, but this shows that she's back on the right track and definitely going to be one to look out for. Also, in the men's 110 meter hurdles, this was supposed to be all about Grant Holloway, but Holloway actually ended up coming in fourth place. Orlando Ortega, we remember last year he had a little mix-up, got crashed out by Omar McLeod in the finals of the 110 hurdles, but he managed to get the win here in a world-leading performance, 13.11 seconds. Just behind him, Andrew Pazzi, who's been very consistent throughout the season, he actually ran a personal best of 13.14 seconds. So great performance for him and all the rest of the guys in the 110 hurdles. Now, we also saw the men's 3,000 meter steeplechase. This was touted as a world record attempt, but unfortunately, Conceslas Kipruto, who has been the most dominant steeplechaser over the past 5 or so years, he tested positive for COVID, so he couldn't come to the meet. But Soufiane El Bakkali, who's been very consistent as well, he managed to come away with the win in an actually very fast time, 8:08.04. So great performance for him. In the women's 100 meters, this was supposed to be a lot about Talu. She was really spoken about, but didn't come away with the win. It was actually Del Ponte from Switzerland. Kind of slow time, 11:16 seconds, but great to see these women back in the 100 meters here. Finally, Manu Duplantis in that men's pole vault. He was going for the outdoor all-time best in the pole vault, which would have been 6:14. He came away with the win in 6 meters flat, took a couple attempts at 6:15, but unfortunately couldn't get the win, couldn't get that there. So definitely keep a lookout for Mondo. He's been having a very long season. Of course, we saw all those world records he broke indoors, so he's hopefully going to get that outdoor world record and go into 2020 on a very high note. All right, so those are the highlights from the Monaco Diamond League. Of course, we also had the women's triple jump, the women's high jump, but keep a lookout for a lot more performances that are going to be coming throughout the season. This is only the first Diamond League that we're going to see for the year. There's a lot more to come. In addition, the Continental Tour is also going to be rolling, so keep a lookout for a lot more performances. Let me know what your favorite performance from the Monaco Diamond League was. Make sure you guys like the video, subscribe to the channel, and we'll be back again next time. Thanks.